Okay, hello everybody. Today's video is about docking with the ISS. So you're going to take off from Kennedy Space Center. First of all, the first thing is choosing a good time to launch. So I've already chosen a time where the orbital plane of the ISS is close to our launch site. If you look at the orbital plane quickly, you can see that it's slightly eastward, and that's good. It's better to have it east than west, because we're going to drift towards the east while the Earth is rotating. Actually, if we switch to ground track, you will see that by the time the ISS passes here, it'll already be much closer. Our speed here is about, due to Earth rotation, is about 350 meter per second, I think. It's basically 40,000 kilometer circumference times cosinus of latitude divided by 86,400 seconds. So 350 meter. Well, let's say 400 meter per second. If we assume that our launch is gonna, until the time to orbit is gonna be 10 minutes, then that would just take 600 seconds times the speed, which is 400 meter per second divided by 2. That gives you 120 kilometers. So if it's nearer, if it's something like 100 kilometer, then it would be optimal. So we would, by the time we are in orbit, we have drifted right into the orbital plane. The other thing is, ideally the ISS is going to be in front of us when we leave the atmosphere, so that we can use a lower orbit to catch up with the ISS. If we arrive in front of the ISS, it'll mean that we either have to catch up, go one orbit more than the ISS, which is going to take quite some time, or we have to go into a higher orbit than the ISS to slow down, but that'll need more fuel, so catching up is better than letting the ISS catch up with us. So if you assume 10 minutes time to orbit, and orbital speed is almost 8,000 meter per second. And we can do the same estimate, 8,000 meter times 600 seconds divided by 2 is 4,000 times 600. Four kilometer times 600 is about 2,400 kilometer. So one of these rectangles is about, I think, a bit more than 3,000 kilometer. So we should make sure that the ISS is about, I don't know whether we can get the exact distance to the ISS using one of these instruments. We can try the docking system. It'll actually tell us the distance, so we'll wait until this is, let's say, below 2,000. And then the other thing is the launch heading. So aligning our orbital planes. Again, we select the ISS. So if our relative inclination was 0, we could just move eastward, just launch 90 degrees, which is eastward, but the ISS is flying in a more southerly direction, so the relative inclination error is 43, so we can just save 90 plus 43. or whichever is the value close to launch. But so that would be one, at the moment would be 133.57 degrees. But we also want to take into account that we have a speed of 400 or 350 meter per second already. So that requires a few more degrees. So let's say the speed orthogonal to our desired speed at the end is, because it's not 90 degrees, it's not full 350 meter per second, but let's say it's 45 degree. Let's say 350 times sinus of 45. That's 247 meter per second, dividing this by 7800 orbital speed. And taking the arcosinus of that, then it means we need to add another 2 degrees. So I think it's a good time to launch now. It's now less than 2000 kilometers away. So we use this value. +44 +2, that's 136 degrees. Let's close the hatch.
External cooling offline using onboard O2.
136 we said. Our heading. We can start our attitude, hold autopilot. Start pitching up. Can increase our airspeed. Climb towards 24 kilometer. We already have achieved our launch heading. That's too much. As you can see, our relative inclination is going down. It's going to slowly go down while we go up into the orbit. So now we need to reduce our climb rate. The climb rate is way too high. can open the scrum doors. To watch our temperature and keep the dynamic pressure at about 10 to 7. Yeah, at the moment we are falling, which is not good. Switch to orbital display.
Mach 9. Mach 10.
Our orientation is slowly going to change just because of the fact that we are flying our orbit. To reduce the climb rate. Switch on the lights, it looks nicer. The scrum temperature is going up, we need to watch that as well. ISS in front of us, which is good.
Mach 18.
Effectiveness of the scrum is going down. Close the scrum doors. Go full thrust and pitch up to get out of the atmosphere.
Mach 20. Rotation.
Let's raise our field altitude to 200 kilometers, so just outside the atmosphere. Relative inclination is nice, small. Field altitude is coming up. Temperature is going down, so we are leaving the atmosphere now. 70 kilometer.
Mach 24. Mach 25. 26.
We can level out the trim.
APU offline.
Switch off the APU.
Mach 26.
We can look at our plane alignment in the next next intersection of the orbits in 1100 seconds. That's quite some time. It's like a quarter orbit. But this is quite optimal. So the next thing that is coming up is lifting our perihelion when we reach the aphel. And then we can use Transax to find a good solution for orbit which matches us up with the ISS. So we fast forward time for a few minutes, like almost 6 minutes. We've reached 140 kilometers height already. We can now deploy the radiator. Turn probe rate. Fast forward a bit more. So now we lift our aphel to also 200 kilometer. Lifted it a bit too much. So I can look for the upcoming plane alignment. It's in just 600 seconds now. Slow Earth orbits are very fast. We're already above South America. So now it's time to look at this. That's a maneuver. See. Let's get a plano view of our orbit. Plan a maneuver. We increase our. We'll do a probe rate burn. And then closest encounter would be 150. So the good thing is we are far enough behind the ISS so that we still have time to do that burn. So if you change the plan. You can plan to bring the distance down to 4 kilometers, which is really good. So we can either do this plane alignment separately. We'll look at what this means in seconds. Or we can actually check this in the view. So it'll be in 700 seconds. We can fast forward time a bit. I think I'll do this burn a bit early.
Translation.
So open our retro doors in case we need retro thrusters. I'll do this a bit early because I don't have much time for the next maneuver, it's in just 200 seconds afterwards. Fortunately, our planes are already pretty well aligned. Let's turn probe rate. Update our solution. Forwarding time again.
Rotation. Translation.
Okay, let's clear the maneuver. Let's see whether we can improve this solution. Add some outward velocity. We've improved our solution. A small didn't change. Basically, we need to start flying towards the station.
Rotation.
It is. We can start to set up the docking. Docking frequency is 100 for the first port, that's 137.4. You're out of range for that, but you can look at the long range transmitter area, I think, which is on 131.3. You get us information when pressing Ctrl I and looking at the description of the ISS in the vessels section. The sun is about to go up. Still 300 kilometers away. Let's fast forward time a bit. The time of encounter is getting closer. So we're basically out of plane, so we need to do a plane alignment. Well, it's not even alignment, basically, we need to fly towards the ISS.
Translation.
That solution is pretty good.
Rotation.
So now we are in range for our docking indicators. It's time to open the nose cone for docking. So the nose cone is now open. The time to encounter can forward a bit more. So the closest encounter is pretty soon. The distances can use a parabola for the this determining the space required. It's like v equal speed to the power of 2 divided by 2 times acceleration. Acceleration is 4, so 2 times is 8, 3600 by 8. Divide by 8 is about 500 meters we need. That's not much. So we can get very close to our closest encounter.
5,000. 4,000. 3,000.
So now we'll slow down. Relative to the space station. And now we'll do a docking maneuver. So now we've switched our HUD to the docking port one.
Translation. Rotation. Translation. Rotation.
You can fast forward time a bit more.
Two thousand. Translation. Rotation. Translation.
You can see the curvature of the orbit. Changing our speed, our relative speed.
900. 800. Rotation. Translation. Rotation. Seven hundred. Translation. Rotation. Six hundred. Translation. Rotation.
Okay, I know rotation already.
500. Translation. Hundred. Hundred.
So now the yellow cross is starting to align as well.
Rotation. Translation. 200.
We have to soon slow down, because our relative speed must not be more than 10 centimeter per second at the end.
Hundred. Seventy-five. Mm-hmm. 50. Forty. Thirty. Twenty. Fifteen. 9 8 7 6 5 4 3 1 Contact.
Oops. Not so we're docking now.
Rotation off. Using external O2. External cooling online.
Can I open the airlock? Okay, that was ISS docking. Thank you for watching.